Oh, I wasn't. I was first of all in the Cumann of Galini, the junior version of it. And then when I was older, I was in the Cumann of Mon for years.
So they had meetings in the Cumann of Mon?
Oh, once a week.
They kept up the Irish tradition.
Oh, they did, Yeah. And then we had marches, like, for different people. I'll tell you a funny story now about it. There was this, we had a meeting. It was very tragic. James McCormack and Peter Barnes were hanged in England for sedition, I suppose we can call it now, but they were hanged anyway in England. And there was a big meeting of those in sympathy, Sinn Féiners, I suppose you could call them. And there was a very nice young man. He was a school teacher called Owen McCorrig. And he had a beautiful speaking voice, lovely now in Irish and English. And he was giving the oration. And there was a woman who was down on the Grand Parade, and there was a woman across the road chatting to some other woman, and she had a very loud voice, and she was kind of interrupting him. She was talking about something else altogether to her friend, her family or something, and he said a few times, "There's a lady over there, and I'm afraid my listeners can't hear her. She's speaking so loud." No, he was a beautiful speaker, and after a bit she shut up, but then after a bit she started off again, and the woman she was talking to was getting a bit embarrassed, and she was saying, shh, you know. So the next thing anyway, he realised that the woman with her, like, wasn't talking at all. So then the next thing he says, she started talking again, and he says, "I'm afraid," he says, "that there's somebody in the crowd who don't know that Peter Barnes and James McCormack have died for Ireland. They had been hanged, you see, in England." And as quick as not, she roared back, "You're a boy, them who dies for Ireland never dies."
Oh, wasn't that lovely, Sheila?
I thought it was the best note I ever heard.